Hi students, in this video lecture we will understand covalent bonding. Before this we have understood electrovalent bonding, and we have seen that electrovalent bonding was formed between a metal and a non-metal. Similarly, covalent bonding will form between two or more metals. So whenever you see any compound that consists of non-metals, you can directly understand that it consists of a covalent bond, right? And since covalent bond is formed between non-metals, right, and we know that non-metals have 4, 5, 6 or 7 electrons in their outermost shell, right, and since non-metals have more number of electrons in their outermost shell, right, it would be difficult for them to lose so many electrons in their outermost shell. Why? Because more energy would be required to remove or to transfer those 4 to 7 electrons from the outermost shell to some other atom, right? So due to energy considerations, it is not possible for non-metals to transfer electrons, because very high amount of energy needs to be given to remove the outermost electrons, 4 to 7 outermost electrons from non-metals, right? And compared to metals, we know that metals have 1, 2 or 3 electrons in their outermost shells, which could easily be lost, which could easily be removed by giving small amount of energy, right? So that is why metals can transfer electrons, right? And non-metals cannot transfer electrons because of energy considerations. More energy is required to remove outermost electrons. So what non-metals will do? Non-metals, instead of transferring electrons, they will share electrons between combining atoms, right, to achieve stable electronic configuration, right? So if we define covalent bonds, now we got to know two things about covalent bonds, that covalent bonds are formed between two or more non-metals, right? Covalent bond is always between non-metals, right? And why non-metals will not transfer electrons and will share electrons? Because of energy considerations, right? Because very high amount of energy is required to remove 4 to 7 electrons from outermost shell. So they will share electrons, right? So if we combine these two things, covalent bond is formed between non-metals by sharing of electrons between the combining atoms, right? Now we'll see and how sharing takes place between combining atoms, right? And non-metals combine through covalent bonds, right? Through, that is, covalent bond means through non-metals will combine through sharing of electrons, right, to acquire 8 electrons in their outermost shell. And after acquiring 8 electrons, both the combining atoms will acquire stability, will become stable, right? Now let's see, let's take example of a simple hydrogen molecule. We see how covalent bond gets formed between hydrogen molecule. Hydrogen molecule formula is H2, that means it consists of 2 hydrogen atoms. So hydrogen atom, this is how we make it, and we know hydrogen atom has 1 electron in its only shell, outermost shell. So, right. So since it has 1 electron, it will try to acquire 2 electrons, because after acquiring 2 electrons, it will become stable. Because 2 electrons means it has acquired helium-like configuration. Helium, which is an inert gas, noble gas, is a stable gas, right? So in order to acquire 2 electrons in its outermost shell, hydrogen will approach another, one hydrogen atom will approach another hydrogen atom, right? And both these hydrogen atom, right, will share their outermost electrons. Since they have 1 electrons, so both will share each other's electrons, right? And once they will share each other's electron, both, this is the shared pair, right? Both have shared their 1-1 electron, so this is the shared pair of electron, right? This is the shared pair, right, which belongs to both the atoms, belongs to both the atoms, right? And we also call this shared pair as bond pair, because it is due to this shared pair that bonding resulted between these two hydrogen atoms, right? So this shared pair is also known as bond pair of electrons, right? So after sharing one electron and resulting into one electron pair, right, both these hydrogen atoms have acquired two electrons in their outermost shell, thereby becoming stable. Both have become stable. So we say hydrogen molecule is a stable molecule. And this shared pair of electrons is the property of both the atoms. That is, they belong to both the atoms now, right? Since it is shared pair. And since there is one shared pair of electron, we write the molecule of hydrogen as this, and this represents a covalent bond, or it also represents this shared pair. This also represents a shared pair of electron, and this shared pair of electron would be equally attracted by both the hydrogen atoms. Right? Imagine that here is a shared pair of electron, and this shared pair of electrons would be equally attracted by both the hydrogen atoms. And it is due to this attraction that both the hydrogen atoms are bonded in hydrogen molecule, right? Because this hydrogen atom is also attracting this electron pair, right? And this hydrogen atom is also attracting this electron pair, right? So both are attracting, so both hydrogen atoms are attracted towards each other. Both the hydrogen atoms are, there is a force of attraction between both the hydrogen atoms due to this shared pair of electron, right? Now let's take another example. Let's take the example of oxygen. Oxygen, we know, has 6 electrons in its outermost shell. Right. So what it has 6 electrons, right? So it needs 2 electrons so that it can complete its octet, that is, so that it can complete 8 electrons in its outermost shell. Once oxygen will gain 2 electrons and form 8 electrons, oxygen atom will become stable. Right? Now let's see how it will gain 2 electrons. Right? Oxygen atom needs 2 electrons, right, to acquire 8 electrons. So both these oxygen atoms will share 2 electrons each, right? This will also share 2 electrons, this will also share 2 electrons, 4 electrons, right? 4 electrons means 2 electron pairs, 2 shared pairs. So both oxygen atoms will share 2 electron each, right? Once it will share 2 electron each, these 4 electrons, right? 4 electrons means 2 electron pairs. Both these electron pairs will belong to now both the oxygen atoms, right? So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This oxygen atom has also acquired 8 electrons. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This oxygen atom has also acquired 8 electrons. Since now both the oxygen atoms have acquired 8 electrons, both oxygen atoms have become stable in oxygen molecule, right? And so we write oxygen as this, right? And this double bond represents 2 pair of electrons, right? That is 2 electrons from each oxygen atom, right? And these shared pair of electrons would be equally attracted by both the oxygen atoms in oxygen molecules, right? And due to which both the oxygen atoms are bonded in oxygen molecule, right? And this, due to this shared pair of electrons, there is a force of attraction between both the oxygen atoms, because this shared pair of electrons is equally attracted by both the oxygen atoms, due to which both the oxygen atoms are attracted in oxygen molecules, are bonded in oxygen molecule, right? So we have a double bond, right, due to sharing of two electrons due to sharing of, or we say due to sharing of two pair of electrons. Now if we take example of nitrogen, I'll just draw the Lewis symbol of nitrogen. We know that nitrogen has 5 electrons in its outermost shell. So nitrogen needs 3 electrons to complete 8 electrons, right? So nitrogen atom has 5 electrons. So to complete 8 electrons, nitrogen atom will approach another nitrogen atom, right? And since one nitrogen atom has 5 electrons, it needs 3 more electrons, right? So both nitrogen atoms will come close to each other and share 3 electrons each, right? 3 electrons sharing from both oxygen atom means 3 pairs of electrons, 3 pairs of shared electrons or bond pair of electrons, right? So 1 2 3, similarly 1 2 3, like this. So both nitrogen atoms have shared 3 electrons, right? So we have 3 pair of electrons sharing in nitrogen molecule formation. So we have 3 pairs, that means 3 bonds, right? 3 shared pair of electrons, or we also call it as bond pair of electrons. So nitrogen has a triple bond due to sharing of 3 pairs of electrons, right? This is how sharing takes place in covalent bond formation, right? So it's clear now, covalent bond is formed between non-metals and formed after sharing of one or more pair of electrons. Depending on the number of pair of electrons, there is a double, single or a triple covalent bond between non-metals, right? So we also say that there are 3 types of covalent bonds or 3 types of covalent molecules. Covalent bonds types: single, double and triple. By single, double, triple, we mean single bond, double bond, triple bond. Single bond due to sharing of one pair of electron, double due to sharing of 2 pair of electrons, triple due to sharing of 3 pair of electrons. We have already understood this. Now this is the case when the similar non-metals are combining using covalent bond. Now let's see some example where different non-metals are combining to form molecules, covalent molecules. Let's take example of hydrogen chloride, HCl. Right? We know that hydrogen has 1 electron in its outermost shell, right? And so it needs 1 more electron, right, to complete 2 electrons, right? And we know that chlorine has 7 electrons in its outermost shell. So chlorine also need 1 electron to complete its octet, that is to complete 8 electrons. So what these two atoms will do when both these atoms approach each other to react chemically, right? Both need 1 electron, right? Since both need 1 electron, they will share 1 electron each, right? If both hydrogen and chlorine in hydrogen chloride molecule will share 1 electron, both will become stable. Let's see how this hydrogen atom has 1 electron. After sharing these 2 electrons, when hydrogen atom has shared 1 electron and chlorine atom has shared 1 electron, both these electrons will become common to both hydrogen and chlorine, right, and will belong to the shared pair, right? And when we know that shared pair of electron is shared between 2 atoms, right? So 1 electron in the shared pair is provided by chlorine and the other electron in the shared pair is provided by hydrogen, right? And this belongs to both. Since this shared pair consisting of two electrons belong to hydrogen 1, 2. So hydrogen has completed its doublet, has acquired two electrons and become stable. Similarly, chlorine, this shared pair also belongs to chlorine, right? This is the shared pair. So chlorine has completed 8 electrons in its outermost shell. And after acquiring 8 electrons, chlorine atom has also become stable. So chlorine is now stable. And what would be the bond? Since there is only one shared pair, so there is a single covalent bond in HCl molecule, right? Now let's take example of before we take some other examples, right? We'll understand what are polar and non-polar covalent compounds, right? And before that, one more thing, the number of electrons shared by the combining atoms. And one more thing, in the covalent bond formation, both the combining atoms will share equal number of electrons. As we have seen in all the four examples, that both the combining atoms, if you see in HCl molecule also, both the combining atoms share same number of electrons. HCl and chlorine both are sharing one electron each. In the nitrogen formation molecule, both are sharing 3 electron each. Oxygen, 2 electron each. Hydrogen, 1 electron each. Right? So this is common for all electrovalent compounds. And the number of electrons that is shared by the combining atoms, right, is termed as covalency. Covalency is the number of electrons shared by each of the combining atoms. Is termed as covalency. Each atom contributes equal number of electrons, which is also termed as covalency. Number of electrons taking part in the formation of shared pair. Right? That is, if this is the shared pair, right, we have three shared pairs. Right? We have three shared pairs. So number of electrons provided by each of the combining atoms in the shared pair is covalency. Here, nitrogen has provided 3 electrons in the formation of 3 shared pairs. Similarly, this nitrogen has also provided 3 electrons in the formation of shared pair, right? So this is covalency, right? Number of electrons shared by each of the combining atoms is covalency. Now let's talk about polar and non-polar covalent compounds. So polarity depends on the electronegativity of the combining atoms, right? We write it as, polarity depends on electronegativity of the combining atoms. Since bond between hydrogen is this, like similarly oxygen is this, similarly oxygen is double bond, nitrogen is triple bond, and we have HCl with single bond, right? And polarity depends on electronegativity, and by polarity we mean polar ends means positive and negative ends. So oxygen, if we talk about hydrogen, let's take the example of first, both these atoms will try to attract this shared pair of electron towards itself. Why? Because both these atoms possess electronegativity, right? Both the atoms possess electronegativity, and we know that electronegativity is the ability to attract the shared pair of electron towards itself, right? In this bond formation, both these atoms will try to attract this shared pair of electron towards itself, right? And in the molecules that are formed from same types of metals, this shared pair would be attracted equally by both the atoms, right? Because we have same atoms. Same atoms means both the atoms will have same electronegativity, that is, the ability to attract the shared pair of electrons would be same from both the atoms, right? So since both the atoms are equally attracting the shared pair of electrons, both these atoms are equally attracting this shared pair of electrons, so this shared pair of electrons will lie in the middle of both the atoms, right? Same is with oxygen, same is with nitrogen, because both the atoms will attract the shared pair of electrons with equal force, and so the shared pair of electrons will lie in the middle of the combining atoms, right? But when we talk about HCl molecule, HCl which consists of a single shared pair, right, we know that chlorine has high electronegativity and hydrogen has low electronegativity. And electronegativity for chlorine is 3.0, I think, and for hydrogen it's 2.1, right? So since chlorine has high electronegativity than hydrogen, so chlorine will attract this shared pair of electron towards itself, right? Due to high electronegativity, chlorine will attract this shared pair of electron towards itself. So since it will attract shared pair of since chlorine will attract shared pair of electron towards itself, it will acquire slight negative charge, right? Similarly, since this shared pair of electron has moved away from hydrogen, so hydrogen will acquire slight positive charge. So these are polarities, positive and negative polarities, right? So to such molecules that acquire polarity due to electronegativity difference, right, such molecules exist as dipoles because of electronegativity difference. Due to electronegativity difference, one of the combining atom due to high electronegativity will attract the shared pair of electron towards itself, thereby acquiring a negative charge, right, and the other atom will acquire a positive charge, right, and hence both these have developed polarities. So such molecules exist as dipoles, right? Dipole means one end is a positive end and the other end is a negative end. Two poles, positive pole and a negative pole, right? So